By teaching you mitosis, or before teaching you mitosis, I told you the 100 trillion cell of our body is divided into two categories. First is somatic cell and second is germ cell. And I had also told you that in somatic cell mitosis occur and in germ cell meiosis occur. So let's see how meiosis occur and what exactly is meiosis. Meiosis is a reductional division. Unlike mitosis, meiosis is equational division. Now, what is the meaning of reductional division? Before that, let's recollect what is the meaning of equational division. In case of equational division, the number of chromosomes remains the same in mother cell as well as in daughter cell. But in case of reductional division, the number of chromosomes gets reduced. From 46, it becomes one cell, that is 23. Now, how it happens, we will study in detail. So, meiosis is a reductional division. Now, over here in the diagram, soon you have seen that mother cell is 2N, where the daughter cell has become N. N means haploid condition and 2N means diploid condition. So, mother cell, which is diploid, is getting half. Their chromosome is half now in daughter cell. And that situation or condition is called as haploid. Now, this is called as reductional division, but it's not completing the meiosis process. It is just the first major stage of meiosis, which is called as meiosis 1. Later what happens, this haploid daughter cell undergo mitosis and they form two daughter cells which have same set of chromosomes. And that result into formation of four cell, which goes according to the definition I taught you. Let me repeat the definition once again. What is cell division? It's a process in which mother cell divide to form two or four daughter cells. Mitosis, two daughter cells are formed. Meiosis, four daughter cells are formed. And how it is formed? Because meiosis have two major stages. One is called as meiosis 1 and the second one is called as meiosis 2. What happens in meiosis 1? In meiosis 1, the diploid mother cell form haploid daughter cell, which is called as reductional division. And again, those haploid daughter cell, now called as mother cell, will divide by mitosis process to form 2-2 haploid daughter cell, and this is called as meiosis 2. Meiosis 2 is exactly the mitotic division. So this is the meaning of meiosis. Now the question arises, in which cell meiosis takes place? Meiosis takes place in germ cell. Where is germ cell present? It is present in the inner lining of ovary in case of female and testis in case of male. And that inner lining is called as germinal epithelium. Those layers consist of germ cells. Now this germ cells helps in formation of gametes. And that is why the conclusion is meiosis occur only in germ cell and that too for a specific purpose, for the formation of gametes. Now let's see what are the various stages of meiosis. Meiosis is divided into two major stages, that is meiosis 1 and meiosis 2. The terms used in these stages are also same, that is karyokinesis and cytokinesis. Cell divides twice, but the nucleus divides once. Meiosis 1 is a reductional division and meiosis 2 is an equational division. That is why meiosis 2 is also called as mitotic division. The term used are same for the division of nucleus as well as for the division of cytoplasm, karyokinesis and cytokinesis. Now we just differentiate it by writing 1 and 2, that is karyokinesis 1 and karyokinesis 2. Cytokinesis 1 and cytokinesis 2, just to distinguish that this is a part of meiosis 1 and this is a part of meiosis 2. So let's see what are the stages accordingly. Now we have same thing in meiosis 2 and it will be termed as karyokinesis 2, cytokinesis 2, prophase 2, metaphase 2, anaphase 2 and telophase 2. Now let's see what are the phases in prophase 1. Now speaking about student meiosis prophase 1, it is further divided into 5 stages. Now let's see what are the 5 stages of prophase 1. So the stages of prophase 1 are liptotin, zygotin, pachytin, diplotin and dikinesis. Now we completed with the meaning of meiosis and we'll continue with the phases of meiosis 1 in the next video. Thank you very much, student.